Hello all, welcome to this video on microprocessors and microcontrollers. In the previous videos, we have gone through the register set, program status word and addressing modes of 8051. With that knowledge in mind, today we'll be solving a program using 8051 assembly language. The question is to write an 8051 assembly language program to find whether a given byte is available in the given sequence or not. If it is available, write double F in R3, else write double 0 in R3. For solving this question, we'll assume a sequence of 5 bytes, namely 15, 4, 6, 45 and 55, which is stored at consecutive memory locations 20H, 21H, 22H, 23H and 24H. We'll use three registers here, R0 for memory address traversal, R3 for monitoring the search as given in the question, and R1 as counter. We'll also use a jump instruction, CJNE, which stands for compare and jump when not equal, which will perform a subtraction between the two operands and jump if the result is not zero. Let us start writing the program. The first statement is ORG0000H. Now, ORG is an assembler directive which stands for origin that directs the assembler to start the memory allotment for a particular segment, block or code from the declared address in the ORG statement. Here the address is 0000H. Now this statement is optional. All the comments to the program is written to the right side using double slash. Now we'll initialize the value of register R0 with the starting address of the sequence, which is 20H. So the statement is written as move R0, #20H. Now hash is used to show that the value is directly specified in the statement. Next, we'll initialize the value of R3. Now, as given in the question, the value of R3 should be 00 until the byte is found in the sequence. So, we'll give it as move R3, #00H. Next, we'll initialize the value of the counter. Since the sequence has 5 bytes, we'll give it as 5 for R1. So it is written as move R1, #05H. The next few statements will take each byte from the sequence and compare it with the value that should be searched for. So before starting the next statement, we'll give a label again, so that when the repetition has to happen, the control will be transferred to this label. So the next statement is to take the value from the register R0 and copy it to A. Now R0 points to the value 20H. To get the value at that particular address, we'll use at the rate of R0. So at the rate of R0 will give the value 15. So here 15 will be copied to the accumulator. Next, the value of R1 is decremented. So R1 is the counter. It was initialized to 5. On decrementing, its value will be 4 and R0 will be incremented. Now R0 will point to 21H. Next, we'll perform the comparison. So subtraction will be performed between the accumulator and the value to be searched for. In this question, we'll assume that 45H is the value to be searched for. Now, a subtraction will be performed between 45 and the value at A, which is 15. So that doesn't give us a 0. Now the jump will be performed and the control will be transferred to the label again. Next, we'll access the value at R0. Now R0 is pointing to 21H. So at the rate of R0 will give us the value 4. 4 is copied to the accumulator and we'll decrement the value of R1. Now R1 will be 3 and increment the value of R0. Now R0 will point to 22H. Next, we'll perform the comparison between the value at A, which is 4, and 45. So on subtraction, they don't give a 0. Again, the control is transferred to the label again. Now we'll access the value at R0, which is 22H. At the rate of R0 will give us the value 6. 6 is copied to the accumulator and we'll decrement the value of R1. So R1 becomes 2 and increment the value of R0. Now R0 will point to 23H. We'll perform the comparison. So the value at A will be 6 and the value 45 is the immediate value. On subtraction, they don't give us 0. Again, the control is transferred to the label again. Now, R0 will be pointing to 23H. So at the rate of R0 will give us the value 45. 45 is copied to the accumulator. Next, we'll decrement the value of register R1 by 1. Now, R1 will be 1 and R0 is incremented. Now, R0 will point to 24H. Then, we'll perform the comparison. Now, A contains 45 and the immediate value is 45. On subtraction, they'll give us a 0. So, since the result is 0, then the execution will start from the next instruction. So, as per the question, when the byte is found, the value of R3 should be double F. So, the next statement will be move R3, #0FFH. Now, we'll end the assembly program with the end directive. That's all for now. Thank you. Thank you for listening.